Hello everybody, welcome to a new episode of How to DIYRC. I hope you like what you see and subscribe. And in today's episode it's all about the JJRC H37 maintenance to keep it in top condition to get the best quality pictures and video from your selfie little drone. Before we're going to test the vibration of this little drone, you have to make sure that your nuts and screws, in this case, of the propellers are tight. So you don't lose them during the test and maybe hit your eye. That would be very dangerous. So you do this for all four motors or four propellers and you check if they are nice and secure. Then we can go ahead and start the test. And the first way you can notice if a motor is going bad is by hearing it. It just makes more noise. And I already can hear that one motor, at least one motor, is making a lot more noise. So that's not a good sign, but it's perfectly for this video to show you how to check it and fix the common problem and get a good video quality. The second way is by touch and eye. So you're going to start the motors and feel each propeller, each arm, and then compare it with the next and see which one is giving you more vibration. It's pretty simple. Oh, this one in the rear is giving me a lot of vibration. But I can also see by eye that this propeller is not straight. It's just wobbling around from left to right. This is the second way that you can check your propellers. That's looking from above and see if the nut, or in this case the screw, is centered. And you can see it wobbling a little bit. So you check it from above and you check it sideways. And you have to see a look if you can see one propeller spinning in the air. If you're seeing two blades, that means your propeller is out of balance and you should balance the propeller or the gear or the motor to get it. And you can see it wobble. This is really bad. It creates extra vibrations and jello towards the camera that you don't want. And to fix the problem of the drone, we're first going to have to power it off and remove the battery. Just to be safe, so you don't circuit out any of the circuit board and destroy your quad. Now that it's safe to work on the quad, we first always going to remove the propellers. And do this for all four propellers. It's pretty normal and standard. And when you have removed all four propellers, it's time to get a magnet, so you're not going to lose all these tiny screws, and you can place them in order of disassembly, so you know how to put them back and into which place you have to put them back, because the is a chance you will find different lengths of screws that will fit only in one place. Now just go ahead and just undo every screw you can find. And in this case there are four screws on each side, in the front and in the rear, and then two screws in the middle that I think holds the whole body together. And there's the last screw, so let's take them out and take it apart. But be gentle. And there's one side coming loose, and just gently poke up the other side. And if any screws are still tight, then just undo them a little bit more. Here it comes. Look at that. Well, there's a pretty strange circuit board. Normally it's very small, and this time it's very long. But it's nice, it balances out the quadcopter. It's a little bit heavier on the back, but still, having a battery in the middle, that is a nice thing. Now all the wires are here, pretty compact. Have a look at that build quality. Soldering job is not the best, but I'm not seeing anything really weird. It looks pretty okay. But I don't like this mess of wires here at the front. Those are a lot of wires just bundled together. But now that we have removed the upper body, we can easily remove the arms out of its case. But be careful, it's all soldered, it's not click on and click off. But now at least we can disassemble each arm and check for any problems. And it was this propeller that was shaking a lot, wobbling from left to right. Let's open it up. But I can see that the screws here are very small, but the screws of the body are pretty long. So you have to keep them separated. Let's disassemble the arm and check what's up. going to be pretty interesting to see how it's working with the gear, or is direct, or is the propeller direct driven from the motor. But I find a rubber O-ring that's going on top of the arm, that is to kill vibrations going to the camera. So that's a good job. And you'll be needing a little screwdriver to push in the little clicking pins to open it up. But shame they didn't use just an extra screw for that. It's so super tight. I do recommend to be very gentle. It's not really the best solution that they use to click on and click open and close off the arm. And I can find there's a little gear running from the motor towards the propeller to give it a little bit more torque instead of RPMs. Now we have opened it up. This is how the motor of one arm looks like when it's disassembled. And it's just a question of looking at this gear. This is cheap plastic. It's not centered perfectly. And there is no bushing in the arm, like with the E58. I got a metal bushing to keep it all nice and straight. But this is just plastic on plastic. And only a little bit of oil. I would like to place some grease there to make it run a little bit smoother. And checking the size of the motors, they are 7 millimeters wide. Just checking the length. And I think my guess is, yeah, there's 2 centimeters. Let's get, yep, exactly 2 centimeters. That's perfect. They are nice and powerful motors for such a little drone. I'm gonna make it interesting to do later a lift test and a thrust test. But now, this is all we're going to have to assemble the motor back in its place. And this is just a click system. So click on, and then the last piece just goes on top and just hold down like a few screws. That's all nice and easy and simple. And the arm is completely fully assembled again. You can put it back in its place. Just make sure that the wires are not going to be stuck on that little arm. Now there was one more arm that we didn't like. There was this one in the rear that we also going to have to check. Putting it off is a lot easier than putting it on. Just also have to disassemble this one really quick. With the second arm that created so much vibrations, we found a really strange, weird problem. Check this out. When I'm turning it the direction it should turn, you can see it's holding back. It's stopping. There's a vibration. There's a blockage. The other way, it spins completely free. No problem at all. Again. You can hear it. It's no good. There's a little issue, and all the gears, check them, look pretty clean. There's no garbage in between them that can cause that problem. The only way that I can fix it now, because it's running smooth the other way around, I'm going to change this arm and turn it for the other way to make it turn counterclockwise instead of clockwise. So it runs smooth, and in the meantime we can wait, of course, until the new arm and parts will arrive, but we can still fly. Because that one motor is spinning rough one way and smooth the other way, I'm just going to change it out for the motor next to it and just desolder the two wires and change them out. I just need to make sure that the wires are, or the motors are, turning the correct way when I solder them back. Luckily we did some pre-maintenance and we fixed it, at least the problem, on time before it gets worse. And in the meantime you can order a spare part for if you really need to replace it in the end. But we can still keep on flying without hurting the motor any more than it's already been hurting all this time. That's a pretty fiddly job. At the same time, we can also improve the solder joints because they are looking pretty rough, the original ones. It doesn't show really the best quality that I would like to have seen with this little drone. But now it's just a time question of putting the motors back in its place and then give it a little test, see if the motors and props are spinning the correct way. And of course this one turns counterclockwise, this motor turns clockwise, this motor turns counterclockwise, and this motor turns clockwise, for you beginners that don't know. But it's, if you know it, it's a pretty simple job. I just have to find the correct propeller that goes with it. and it scoops when it's counting, turning counterclockwise. So that goes on this motor that turns counterclockwise, and this propeller scoops clockwise, so that's going to go on the motor that turns clockwise. And then of course don't forget the screws to put the props on its place, and they don't take off during the test flight. And then we connect the battery, of course, and do a pretty simple test. Make sure the motor sits quite out of place. It's a bit tricky, of course, you don't want that. But I'm not going to assemble the whole drone and then to find out that the motors are spinning the wrong way, and then have to disassemble everything again. So we always do a simple check, but it's a quick one. And then, and this little button right here at the end, that is the on and off switch. So we have assembled the arms and put it back in place, because this is one problem that we have solved. There's one problem less that can cause any issues during flight. Now it's just going to be interesting to see the rest of the components of this little drone. So let's take off the lampshade. We'll take and remove the camera with it. And there's not a lot of space. I'm going to just check and show you guys that little camera. Because it's really, it's just as big as my pinky. It's a super small camera. And behind it, we have a little red board that connects the camera. And then at the back we have a small, shows up really bad. As you can see behind the board of the red camera, there's a little blue board. That is the Wi-Fi module that sends out the connection with your telephone. But I'm looking at it, looking for an antenna. It shows up really bad, but there's one small little antenna right over here that runs to the Wi-Fi module, so that's for the Wi-Fi connection. And then I was looking at the circuit board, and you can find here antenna, and they put just a joint of solder on it. So if you're going to add our own antenna over here, you can extend the range by a whole bunch. Definitely when you're flying in a noisy area with a lot of Wi-Fi FPV, will decrease the range of your little drone. Of course, this is a selfie drone, you're not going to be flying far away anyways, but just in case, it's always good to have the best connection that you can get and add your own antenna. And we have found a little spare antenna. It's little, I would love to have it a little bit bigger, because the bigger the antenna, the longer it is, the more range you get. I tested it several times, and it's also smart to let the antenna stick outside the canopy to get some better connection with your transmitter. And of course do the same with your transmitter. So now we have seen all the components of the drone, we have improved the arms, we have improved the range with the antenna, we have checked the FPV. So now this little antenna, I'm gonna just put a let it poke on the lower side of the body and let it just poke out, and this antenna will poke out on the top of the canopy. And looking at the quality, I'm not really impressed, but I do like that it's a really small, tiny package. You need to consider that. It's not an easy job to get it so small as this. And when it's folded down, it really fits in your pocket. You don't need a bag. It's really nice that it put, of course, an extra pouch with it, but you don't need it. Now I'm just going to put all the components back in this place, being very carefully. They made the margins of the plastic very small. This is all just a tight fit. That's a good thing. That means that there's less things that are vibrating loose, and it creates so much less vibration towards the camera and giving you better video quality. So that's a good thing, but it's pretty difficult and naggy job to put it all back together. And of course, don't forget to put the four rubber O-rings on top of the arms. That is also killing vibration that is going towards the camera. And also towards the gyro, so the gyro will be also a lot more happier, because vibrations are stressing out a gyro, making it fly a lot more out of balance. Let me say, it will be a lot more tricky, a lot more jumpy, and not so smooth. The less vibrations that's going towards the gyro, the smoother your drone will fly, and therefore the smoother your camera footage and video will be. Well, we have placed those four rubber pieces, and now we're just going to put that canopy back in its place. But first we're going to poke a hole, and to poke a hole in the canopy to make some room for the antenna, we're gonna use my soldering machine. Just poop, really quick and dirty fix. Yep, that's enough. Now we are going to put the canopy back on its place. We have to poke the antenna through that little hole that we made. And we need to be very careful with the motor wires, that we are not going to damage them in any way. And they will still run smooth. And the O-rings will stay in its place. That's pretty important that you don't lose those. Check all four arms if they are sitting correct. And if it's all sitting nice and tight, and there's not enough a lot of space in between, then we can start off the way we ended, and that's using the two middle screws for the body at first, and then going around to the four screws in the rear and in the back. When you screw down the screws, you don't want to over tighten them and run out the threads, but you do want to make it tight so that you don't lose them during flight. And after each flight, you want to check if they are still in this place, or you have to tighten them up so you don't have a bad flight the second time around. Now it's time to put the propellers back on its place, and I'm just gonna show you one way. You can see that it's scooping when it's turning counterclockwise. That means it needs to go on a motor that turns counterclockwise. And these two motors are spinning towards each other, and these two motors are spinning towards each other. And that means that this one is counterclockwise, and this one is counterclockwise. And these two are clockwise. And this prop needs to turn counterclockwise to create lift, because it's scooping. And you can see the way it scoops. It's turning counterclockwise. Just say it three times, because a lot of people don't know. There are a lot of beginners that are buying these quadcopters. They can make a little mistake. We just have to help you guys wherever we can. And just going to screw the propellers. And then we have two propellers that turn clockwise to create lift. Now that we have finished the full assembly of the JJRC H37 drone, it's time to do one more test before we're going outside for a test flight. And that's checking if the motors and the propellers are spinning the correct way. Let's take off. Whoa. But at takeoff, that meant that the motors and the propellers are turning the correct way and sitting on the right place. And that means it's ready to go outside and do a test flight. But this video of the maintenance guide is going to stop over here. I really hope this video was helpful to you guys and you will be giving it a lot of thumbs ups. If it wasn't, well, then give it a thumbs down. And if you have any questions, then leave it down below in the comment area. And I hope you subscribe for the next episode. We're going to do a test flight. And I'm going to say goodbye. Until next time.